Troy Woolfolk here with AnnArbor.com, Big Ten Football Media Days. Troy, first of all, how was your summer?
Summer was good. Got a lot of sun, got a little tan. I loved it. Reminded me of Texas a little bit. I got to go home. I actually just came from being home, so summer's been great so far.
You've always regaled us with stories about your dogs or whatever. What's your best story from summertime?
Well, actually, the best story happened while I wasn't even home. I had some girls watching my dog, and they brought another dog over. So I have a little glass table, and the other dog jumped onto the glass table, and then my son Julius came and jumped on the table in pursuit of the dog, breaking it and shattering the glass everywhere, which was just recently purchased, which I'm kind of mad about, but it's okay.
He doesn't have a paternity suit on his hand, does he, Julius?
No, he's okay. He'll be good.
All right, let's talk about football. Two straight losing seasons. I know it's not exactly what you guys wanted. You're entering your senior year now. What's the biggest reason for hope?
It's we're just hungry now. I'll just tell you, because you can see that even though we have losing seasons, but it's been progressively getting better. And I think this is a year where we're going to be trying to get better. We're going to be trying to win every game. I predict that. I don't want to make predictions because I'm against that, but I hope that we at least win 8 games, because anything else below that would be disappointing for not just only me, but the team and the rest of the fans.
How about the secondary? I mean, that's an area that obviously there's going to be some change this year, some new faces. You're one of the vets. What can we expect out of the secondary this year?
I'm a vet. Ooh, that's scary. But I think that we made new defensive changes, which allow people to play faster. We made defense more simplistic for the younger players, so I think the younger players will be able to make a more impact for the team.
Rich, just talk a little bit about that. It's not a true 3-3-5. I mean, he simplified some things and just kind of incorporating some things.
I don't know why they keep saying 3-3-5. I actually not am sure what it is. I think it's more of like a hybrid defense or something, which just makes it more easier for people to react, because sometimes these young players come to college and they're focused on trying to understand the grand scheme of the defense and not being able to react to the ball. So he had a great idea of making it easier so that reaction time would be better. So I think the younger players have a better impact on the team, too, as well.
Now, offensively, Denard Robinson seemed to make some strides during spring. Tate Forcé obviously started every game last year, and everybody knows about Devin Gardner, tremendous talent. Can you just talk about that position battle a little bit, and how important is it for you guys to get a starter before the start of the season?
I actually think it's not really that important to have a solidified starter. I think as long as we have 3 quarterbacks that can play, they all should get a chance to play, because why not? It brings a different aspect and makes it harder for other people to scheme a defense against them.
Who is going to start against UConn, though?
I actually have no idea. It's going to come back and hit me up after second week of camp, and I'll tell you. I'll be on the set.
Yeah. All right. So last question. We'll get you out on this. Everybody knows about David Molk, Mike Martin, those guys, the things that they do in the weight room. You've been around your teammates all summer. Give me somebody off the radar that we can maybe expect some big things from this year, maybe something you've seen in the weight room or on the field otherwise.
I have to say JT Floyd. I actually don't look at him in the weight room because you might be discouraged because he's kind of weak. But he's a great player. He bloomed this spring. He shocked me making interceptions every time they threw his way. So I think he's going to be a late bloomer and surprising people on the field.